to the Final Four. We come to you today from Lexington, Kentucky. They will fill up Rupp this afternoon for SEC action. Number 25, Alabama taking on fourth-ranked Kentucky. The conference standings, the Wildcats tied for second behind Auburn. The Crimson Tide enter action in fifth place. And welcome courtside, everybody. I am Eagle Bill Raftery, the rest of our CBS crew. Great to be with you. This is a rematch from 2 weeks ago. It was a Kentucky win in Tuscaloosa, but they don't have their starting backcourt here today. They're going to be shorthanded. No Ty Washington, no Sahvir Wheeler.
Davion Mintz has to carry the load, just like you have to carry the load here today. Of course, not only offensively, defensively, Shaq, but importantly, so tough to keep out of the lane. Major issue.
Let's take a look at our fast analysis graph. It's presented by AT&T 5G.
When you talk about KY Oscar, Sheway, just a monster on the glass. Great anticipation. Follows Karams, anticipates where the ball's coming up. He's got a motor, keeps on going, but on the other end, quickly able to get in the lane. Shackelford as well. If they make their threes and get in the lane, it's going to be a tough night for Kentucky.
As we check out the starting lineups this afternoon for Alabama, very talented group with Quinterly, Shackelford, Ellis up front. Gurley getting the start along with the freshman seven-footer, Bediako. Kentucky, Mintz, Grady, both grad transfers, both very experienced. Mintz in his second year with the program. Keon Brooks, Jacob Toppin, who was a bit of a question mark himself, dealing with an ankle issue, and Oscar Tshiebwe, the leading rebounder in college basketball. Nate Oates, now in his third year with the Crimson Tide. It's been an up-and-down year, and there's a high ceiling for this team. This is a group that could easily get hot come March. And John Calipari came out this week and said that this is the team that he wants to coach, the type of team that could do serious damage when the tournament comes around. Now it's about getting healthy and getting those guys ready.
Alabama likes to play top 10 teams, by the way.
That's true. They do
exceedingly well. On the other end, John Calipari, they were on a nice run. These injuries have set them back a little bit. Be interesting to see the rotations of Kentucky. They're liable to play a lot bigger at times and obviously move different people to the two spot.
Kentucky suffered a 76-63 loss at Tennessee on Tuesday night, and that snapped a six-game winning streak. We've got a veteran crew in Pat Adams, Keith Kimble, and Olandis Poole here today in Lexington. That first meeting, 66-55 Wildcats win. Five Kentucky players in double figures. It was the lowest scoring output of the season for Alabama.
And right now, I ain't either. Kentucky goes into the man. I think we're going to see a lot of woo-woo going up and down here, Bird.
And a change for Alabama. Juwan Gary is in there. The flip doesn't go for Quinterly to open action. And they clear it for Shackelford. So that's Gary, the sophomore wearing the mask, suffered a facial fracture against LSU. Half-court set here for the Crimson Tide. Shot clock winding down. Quinterly missed it. Didn't hit the rim. Should have been a shot clock violation.
You're right. Look, he can make that deep one.
And he does.
Ooh, he gets it going, Shackelford. They make their threes, and they're judicious in the type of threes they take. Plus, getting in the lane, they are a very difficult out.
36% from downtown. Shackelford gets the scoring started. Mintz puts it on the deck, clears it for Grady. Came over from Davidson. Did play point guard at Davidson for a few years, then shifted off the ball. Tshiebwe on a kick. The jumper, Brooks cans it.
He plays well or a different team. Runs the floor great. And gets some numbers, some serious numbers for this team.
Alabama riding a three-game winning streak since the loss to Kentucky. Wins over Ole Miss, Arkansas, and Mississippi State. A tight one the other night. Clear it. Ellis got a three.
Well, they are ready to play both these teams.
I mentioned Brooks, how about the game against Kansas that this kid had? Knocks down big numbers, rebounds.
And a 6-2 advantage for Alabama, ranked 25th in the country. Toppin hands it off for the veteran Mintz.
They like to weave it a little duck in. He's got that little jumper, but loves that quick release on the hook.
Bank shot doesn't go. Tshiebwe gathers in for the offensive board. That's why he's number one in the nation.
Incredible.
Mintz uses the screen. Can't hit the jumper. Good box out there by Bediako. Alabama up by four. 2 minutes gone by.
And a little double up top. And a replace.
Swing. two-man game with Quinterly and Ellis.
What a handle this kid has, by the way.
Quinterly, a deep shot, air ball. And it's put home by Bediako in the right spot.
The advantage on a miss of the rim is to the offensive team. Everybody else looking to block out. He can make that shot. Now he's working hard on that this year.
Tshiebwe knocks it down from the outside. Transfer from West Virginia, putting up 16 points and over 15 rebounds per game, and a block and a half plus two steals. Ellis makes his move.
Pretty.
Elevation for Keon Ellis, going hard to the hole.
Bediako out high. Tshiebwe not in the area to defend.
10-4. Alabama's offense flowing early.
Ellis can really guard.
Brooks, the jumper is good. Keon Brooks was shooting a lot of jumpers from that spot in the pregame warm-up, and it pays off on his first attempt.
Yeah, I mentioned that 27-point game against Kansas. He can get some numbers.
Corner, high arcer, Jawan Gary nails it for three.
Boy, are they ready to play.
Alabama, 5 of 8 from the field, 3 of 4 from downtown.
No, you can't leave this kid.
Nice. Brady, book it, it's a three.
It's available, very alert. You can't sneak a peek and cheat off of him, big time.
Some guys on the team call him Granddad. He's been around for a while. Beautiful drive and the deuce. It's Quinterly.
Do you have something against Aiden?
No, I'm just passing along information.
Vital information.
He's the OG. 15-9, Alabama.
They get so many possessions because of Tshiebwe's ability to hit that offensive glass.
Tshiebwe trying to drive in. The ball was deflected. Brooks retrieves it. Open look. Mintz off the rim from three-point territory. And the rebound ricochets to Shackelford.
He's had two good, clean looks. Mintz got to knock him down.
All five nice starters at the court. Down low and a slam. Bediako.
That's their bread and butter, that high ball screen roll. You got to bump him in the lane.
After the made basket, Kentucky gets it up the floor in a hurry, but they can't stop Alabama. Contact, and a blocking foul is called. It will be Bediako picking it up. Tshiebwe throwing his weight around.
If you don't defend this high ball screen and that dump to the lane, you are going to be put to bed early. Weak side has to be conscious. And Bediako, big time, send it in Lexington, KY.
10 years ago, national title for Kentucky. John Calipari and company, Anthony Davis, the standout, Michael Kidd-Gilchrist on that squad, and he is in attendance here this afternoon. Earlier today, the bracket preview show on CBS with Greg, Clark, and Seth. Right now, number one seeds would be Gonzaga, Auburn, Kansas, Arizona, Kentucky slotting in as a two seed currently in the East.
Now, what would you say? Kentucky is playing without two of their starters. This game will be considered on the same level as if they were here.
It will.
Basically, you know, so tough. You know, Ty is such a terrific performer. And, of course, Wheeler, his ability to get in the lane and also to guard. Fun. A lot of even teams this year. Going to be magical.
Between the two of them, they're missing 22 points. And, obviously, Wheeler, one of the best assist men in the country. Get it inside, out of the timeout. Brooks wheels towards the rim and puts it in.
Took advantage of Miles there. Brooks' size runs the floor.
And Billy, first 2 points in the paint for Kentucky. It's 8-2 Alabama. J.D. Davison, the explosive freshman, now on the floor for the Crimson Tide.
Yeah, you can say that again. Explosive, incredible at the rim. Really developing his game, too. A little struggle here with the ball.
Miles nearly lost it. Noah Gurley in. Miles with the shot clock running down. He could shoot it. Missed it from three-point territory. Up high for the rebound is Toppin.
Boy, talk about elevation. Grady needs a lot of bumps. Might have to use the dribble to get free.
Swing it. Mintz gets popped by Davison. Alabama leads it 17-11 as we get closer to the SEC tournament. This is what the numbers look like for Alabama and Kentucky. Two high-scoring teams. Kentucky number one in three-point shooting in the SEC. Alabama can get hot. They shoot as often as anybody. They did not shoot it well the last time these two teams played from three-point territory. 3 of 30.
Low numbers that game, too.
Shot clock winding down. Grady makes his move. The sweeping maneuver by Kellen Grady.
Well, when you shoot it like him, they're going to hug you. You got to use that bounce.
Both teams shooting it well. Alabama 7 of 10. Kentucky 6 of 9. Good offensive showing here in the early going.
Trying to get it to the elbow.
Davidson gives it up. Working around the perimeter. Ellis will take and make the three.
Now, you watched that yesterday. The ball comes out like a screwball.
Yeah.
I know you played a lot of baseball in your day. But it just got a little reverse angle. It turns right on him.
It's a knuckle. It's a Phil or Joe Negro.
Exactly. No, that's a knuckleball.
Oh, that's different. 20 to 15, Alabama.
There's that horn set again. Now, really doing a nice job on the perimeter. Kentucky is so talented. You overlook their defense. Really always jump dribble lanes, passing lanes.
Davidson looking to create some space. He does. Bank shot doesn't go. And a rebound cleaned up by Shibwe. Mintz with some pace.
There you go again. Oh, you can't give him that look.
The open shot goes down. Grady missed it. Shibwe clears it. Jacob Toppin drive and kick.
Boy, nice job getting free by Mintz.
Toppin's open. Offensive board. Wouldn't go down for Brooks. And a battle on the glass finally claimed by Alabama's Gurley.
And good officiating though.
Oh, deep one. Shackelford. Making it rain from the outside.
Boy, that opens up things in the low post area for dribble drives though. Boy, getting those puppies organized, Bird. He has some beautiful stroke. They get that going. The ability to put it in the lane and kick. This is just a little simple exchange. Nylon 15.
Alabama has come out firing. 5 of 7 from three-point territory. Now look at the comparison from the first meeting against Kentucky when we talked to the head coach, Nate Oates. They charted everything, so the 3 of 30, when they looked at it on tape, they said 2 of the 23 were uncontested threes.
Do you believe everything Coach is saying?
I just write it down.
The numbers, it's amazing what they chart, though. You know, this team, they get it going out there. They are just magical.
So Oates was comfortable with the shots that they took. They just didn't make them. Jump shot doesn't go for Brooks. Rebound knocked out of bounds and last touch by Alabama. Change here. Bryce Hopkins is in the game. Multi-dimensional 6'6", 220-pounder from Oak Park, Illinois.
A good-looking prospect, really. Corner threes, rebounds, got a little toughness in him. Nice mid-range game, too. Play again. He's quick.
Catching fire is off the mark from Kellen Grady. Kentucky has missed its last 5 shots. Looking to take a double-digit lead.
Oh, he's explosive and gets to the rim quickly. Nice hands cover the corner.
Hopkins. He couldn't grab it. Davison put it out there. And Alabama will retain possession with just about 8 minutes gone by, first half.
At this level, you've really got to play your own guy because of the ability of those corner threes. Everybody locks their man in that baseline position. You've got to stay in control.
Hopkins has a 6'10 wingspan as he deflected it. Davison, dribble drive, and that time it's intercepted. Mintz steps in.
Got Hopkins a little late.
Mintz gets to the rim. Davion Mintz had the patience and just waited it out until the very end.
A pretty good defensive stand to set it all up.
Gurley, not shy, hits a three.
Whew. Showing some range too, huh? Big fella.
He's willing to step outside. 6'8", 215 pounds, grad transfer from Furman, the Paladins.
Very good.
Thank you.
That's his 17-3. He had 2 threes against Ole Miss. He can shoot a little bit.
Crossover, Toppin gives it up for Mintz. 26-17, Alabama. Mintz, head and shoulder fit. Spin. Mintz tried to bank it in. Offensive board. The putback doesn't go, but a foul. Damian Collins now in the game. Another freshman from the state of Texas. He'll shoot free throws when we come back to Lexington. Board shooting, that's been the story so far for Alabama.
And Bert, there's so many guys that can make it. Of course, the little
freeze drill with the lefty Ellis, a guy that can pop them. This time the dribble drive, that is when they are devastating. In that lane, that's that 47 by Ellis, and he is known as a defender. But once again, Shaka for deep range, and all of a sudden, you got the ability to get some stuff in the post.
6 of 8 from downtown. Kentucky is just 1 out of 3. Alabama actually came into Rupp last year, got a win, 85-65. They had lost 8 consecutive here in Lexington prior to that.
He swept them last year. Look, there's Cal going to that bench, playing a little bit bigger. Tight. Tough to see a great talent like this kid. He gave it his all.
It's a lower leg injury for Washington. Suffered it against Florida last Saturday.
And tried against Tennessee, right?
He did.
A few minutes.
Meanwhile, Wheeler has been dealing with what appears to be a wrist issue.
The biggest thing with Wheeler missing is defensively. I mean, he's got foot speed that can counter the perimeter guys. Davison and Quinterly, they are devastating the way they decimate your D.
26-19, Alabama in front.
Nice screen.
Clean look. Ellis from deep. Crimson Tide are lethal in this first half.
And Rojas with a great screen to set it up.
Dish Hopkins.
Another good play there.
Couldn't get there because of the defense by Jawan Gary. Great opportunity. Kentucky floor balance defensively.
Allen on the floor now. One is a shooter. That'll give everybody a little touch.
Davison, short. Rebound is snatched by Hopkins.
Pretty good defender. He jumps passing. They got a piece of that one earlier. Time in the right spot.
They get Collins a touch. And he's fouled on the delivery. So extending out Rojas, who gives Alabama that physical edge. And he's called for the personal.
He's had some serious hops, by the way, Collins. You know, those NBA drills that they use, he outleaped the leap machine, if that's possible.
42-inch vertical for Damian Collins. McDonald's All-America. Grew up playing football. Was a quarterback, then a wide receiver, and then he just kept growing and growing. And basketball became his calling. 7'5 wingspan.
I think with the physical presence he has, he chose properly, don't you think?
I'm going to say yes. Collins is now 4-4 at the free throw line. Nate Oates looking sharp in that jacket, Bill.
Very much so. He's got a number of them. Not quite Wimp Sanderson, but getting there, you know. Wimp does a radio show as well.
29-21, Crimson Tide.
Nice kick. That's where they're tough.
Gary probing, blocked by Brooks, and a foul is called.
They really went right back into him. Smart with those arms up there. The dribble drive again, no post up. The ability to get a touch in the lane makes them an awfully tough out.
It is their first trip to the free throw line, Jawan Gary. So you admire the look of Nate Oates, the sartorial splendor. Wimp Sanderson.
Wimp, yeah.
Here's the thing. Many people don't realize Bill Raftery had his own collection in the 80s. You know that, right?
Do I know it?
Yeah,
absolutely. You always have to look sharp on the sideline, particularly if your team's struggling. Ooh, almost a steal by Rojas.
And it's blocked on the inside with a foul call.
Go top him with a nice look.
That's number 2 on Rojas. There it is, Bill.
Ooh.
Look at that.
The turtleneck, too, going.
Was that at Sears? Where could I get those?
Corvette City.
You had a deal?
A little darkness in the hair, too.
A little darkness. You had the hair of a congressman.
Mm-hmm.
Like, beautiful head of hair.
Indicted congressman?
No, I don't want to go that far. All right, a couple of substitutions here with Alabama making changes. Crimson Tide have to be thrilled with what they've produced offensively so far. They have 29 points. We just cracked the halfway point of this first half.
They get 80, as does Kentucky, but then when they play a little lesser minutes. They are primed, though.
Shibue back in, replacing Damian Collins.
Gave him some good minutes.
So Alabama now with Quinterly, Ellis, Bediako back in, Shackelford, and Miles rounding out the five. Ellis,
nice pop.
Ball fake, jumper. Oh, he's feeling it. Keon Ellis is locked in.
Oh, that was contested, too, by Toppin.
And the Crimson Tide up by 10. Mintz looking to get others involved here. Grady.
Once again, Grady's going to have to do with the dribble. They are not leaving him.
Entry. Foul call. Shibwe, 71% shooter, will get a pair.
A nice shot going at Bediako. I mean, how about this? Getting those puppies ready. Unbelievable pump, bite. And despite the challenge and the blow by there, and they do that great, Kentucky, on the shooting side, not to get involved or engage with the other body.
Second foul on Bediako. Oscar Shibwe. The Oscar goes to Shibwe. I get it.
Clever. Bediako is going to get a little bit of a blow here, I think. Those are those two fouls that you mentioned. He may get the big Oscar, this kid, with his numbers all year.
Averaging that double-double, contributing in so many different areas. Mid-range abilities, as you pointed out. And just a dominant rebounder with that big frame, 6'9", 255.
And he's charming. Something you could learn a great deal from.
I felt
great smile. A linguist, too.
Quinterly.
Well, he can really handle.
Small against big.
And that's when they usually cut. But nobody dove to the rim.
Skip pass. Oh! Wow. Keon Ellis cannot miss.
And they were worried about his foot yesterday, if you remember. He was asking, are you okay? He said, I'm ready to go. He certainly is.
5 of 5 from downtown. And Alabama's got its largest lead. Swing it. Toppin. The drive. The floater is good.
Nice sealer. Shibwe, though. Open. Entree to the rim.
Swing it. They didn't even look for Ellis. The jumper doesn't go. For Gurley.
And they are very good, Alabama. Speed to rebounds, too. You got to get the long caroms on missed threes.
Entry. Brooks. Turnaround. Short. Uncontested rebound for Ellis.
Ooh. And Ellis was throwing it away.
Set it up for Shackelford. He fires off the rim. Kept alive. And the ball got knocked around as Ellis secured the offensive rebound. Thanks in large part to the play of Gurley. 35-26. Alabama is rolling. Here at Rupp Arena, game summary. Alabama is scorching hot. 9 of 14 from three-point territory. They have turned it over just once. And Ellis with 17 points to lead the way.
And Bird, the way they spread the floor, Keon Ellis has been sensational. Look at all this area here you have to cover. It's just impossible because that opens up dribble opportunities. They don't have a low post presence. But your help side defense, you can just forget about it. Stay at home, play your own, contain the dribble drive. Stay down on the floor on those pump fakes, but he has been tough. You mentioned the five. That's 51 threes now. Get them in a hurry.
Ellis did not score against Mississippi State. John Calipari's squad having a tough time stopping the Crimson Tide in this first half.
And they hold people to under 30% from three as well.
Kentucky leads the SEC in scoring at 80.6 points per game. Alabama just behind them at 80.4. And right now they're looking at more than that. Ellis is human.
Pretty good preparation by Kentucky on a double screen. The inbounder, the tough out.
Davion Mintz gives up his dribble, clear it for Toppin.
The problem for Grady, they can't run those floppy bumps on the baseline.
Oh, major rack attack from Jacob Toppin.
Effortless. Fluid. House trying to get in a little bit.
35-28, Alabama.
Oh, that's a settle. I don't think that's a good trip.
Quinterly misses, one and done for the Crimson Tide.
Yeah, you can't stay hot. That's why they need that touch in the lane. Nice pump.
Ball fake. Mintz tried to slip it inside. Brooks loses it and now recovers. 7 minutes to play in this first half.
Boy, Quinterly's on Brooks there to take advantage of that. Get him in the box.
Triple drive. Mintz.
Tough shot.
Missed it off the backboard and rim.
Not good recognition without Wheeler.
Get it ahead. The acceleration. Swatted. Out of bounds. Brooks ranges over to make the play on Shackelford.
A little more involved in the game. And this is just a terrific little dribble drive. And once again, staying locked on the shooters gives him that opportunity. Boy, how graceful, huh? Big time. Send it in.
Toppin, junior, very springy, transferred from Rhode Island.
Mm-hmm.
Averaging just over 6 points, three rebounds per game.
Yeah, same thing. Dangerous guys, the inbounder. They really handled it well, Kentucky, on that double screen.
Gurley was asking for it. Can they get it to him? Plenty of time on the shot clock. Gurley against Toppin. Turn around, book it.
What a nice call from the sideline now. Not making those threes. Stay in touch. Deep.
37-28, Alabama. Running one-hander doesn't go for Grady. Break opportunity here for Shackelford.
Numbers, too, if they don't go quickly.
Swing it. Davison back in. We approach 6 minutes to play in this first half. Crossover. Davison, the bump, the bucket.
How quick. Slithers through a little tiny opening. Hair and all.
Terrific athlete, a highlight waiting to happen. This matches their largest lead. They need this. Brooks missed it off the heel.
A run out here.
Up ahead. Davison dangerous in the open court. He got caught in no man's land, and they were fortunate not to turn it over.
That's how quick Quinterly is, though.
Quinterly settles in. Now it's Gurley. Baseline drive, tough angle. Noah Gurley using that length. And a timeout called by Kentucky.
Now the big guy's doing a nice job, whether it's Gurley or Gary. A nice little attack here. Big time. No one to the 10, but a little kiss.
Alabama, 9 of 16 from long range, 7 of 11 on two-point attempts, and they've opened up a 13-point advantage.
A nice mixture, really. Here we get Greedy. He's got to keep busy, though. There's that little triangle set they like to run.
Lance Ware in the game.
Brings some energy, this kid. Like his attitude on the floor.
Shibwe gives it up. Jumper, Grady.
Nice hit and follow. Nice handoff by the big fella.
A deep hit for Kellen Grady. Play for Bob McKillop at Davidson. Was a star there, over 2,000 career points.
Pretty darn good coach, right? Oh my goodness, what a great job he's done there.
Gurley gives it up. Nice. Shackelford. And it's out of bounds. Last touched by Kentucky and Grady.
Well, the referee was actually out of bounds, but Grady with a nice little hit and follow on the other end. He's going to have to use the bounce to keep busy.
We are under 5 minutes to play in this first half. Alabama shooting 59% overall.
We're doing a little politicking on the baseline. And Toppin.
It's a long conversation with Pat Adams. And the officials are going to come together here.
They can't be looking for anything.
It might be blood. That might be the issue that they have to have dealt with.
Well, working with you, I had a couple of injuries myself over the years. Amazing, though, Nate being a high school coach. And I think Bobby Hurley went to recruit and got to know him a little bit, then brought him to Buffalo.
Romulus High School in Michigan.
Yeah. And I'm told that he spent a lot of time with Tom Izzo going to practice and to learn. Hold on, we're going to get the answer here.
Possible flagrant.
So a possible flagrant foul is what the officials are taking a look at right now. Pat Adams has the headset on.
Ware must have been involved in it.
Well, that was the long conversation,
right?
You mentioned where the officials were talking to both Ware and to Toppin The call was made immediately. Ball was out of bounds. Alabama retains possession. Bruiser Flint now a part of the Kentucky coaching staff.
One of my favorites. Bruiser played at St. Joe's. Of course, great job at Drexel, up at UMass, and then at Indiana for a while, and back down with his old pal. Pat getting a little air time here.
Well, for this Alabama team, it's been that roller coaster ride, but they know what they're capable of based on their talent level. They just have not shot it well from three-point territory. Sometimes they do, like today, but 31%. So this was the issue. Wearing Miles, and then Miles stuck his hand up.
I think they will call it. He shouldn't have done it, obviously. Nothing malicious, but a little whooping precipitated it.
They were talking, and then the officials did catch it. So the bodies were bumping a little bit. Definitely words exchanged. And then they kept on talking. I think the officials were ready to let it go. And then as the conversation continued, that's when they blew the whistle and had a longer talk with Ware and Miles. You talk to anybody with Alabama, they'll tell you that Darius Miles does talk a lot.
A little bit.
He's chatty, very likable.
But have you spent time with him?
I have not.
You've just been told.
I didn't notice at practice that
he was engaging, though.
Bouncing wildly.
Once in a while, the game wants him to be a little more serious about his practice habits.
Yep.
And John voicing his displeasure.
But now here's the thing now. They've seen what we've seen.
Mm-hmm.
And at some point,
I think you've
got to make a call.
I would say it's a flagrant one, just putting the hand on somebody's face.
Can't do it. That's all.
Look at the rules here.
They'll let him talk a little bit. They'll let him jaw.
I did say Ware brought energy. I didn't mean the woofing energy. Maybe a double. A dead ball technical. And then, if that's what they do, no flame would maybe a dead ball technical and possession error.
Remember, Alabama was going to hold on to the basketball based on the out of bounds. The ball hit the official standing on the sideline.
Right.
And now they're trying to determine exactly what's going to play out here.
Well, it looks like they're going to shoot something. I saw with two fingers. Hold on.
We have a dead ball contact on red number two. All right. So we're going to shoot two and put it to the side. Put the top. Dead ball contact on red number two. All right.
Yep.
We're going to put the ball right up out of bounds for Alabama right here. Okay.
Thank you, Keith.
Two
free throws for Kentucky. The foul called on Darius Miles.
Contact.
Sticking his hand up in the face of Ware. And Alabama will have possession when they finally clean this up.
John wants to go. Let's go. Well, he's in his face, too. It is taking a long time.
It was a long stoppage, and this game had a very good rhythm to it. If you're Alabama, Kentucky,
that's a great point.
Find some things.
You're right. It might be to their advantage.
John Calipari, as this thing dragged on, he and Pat Adams were nose to nose.
Boy, that's like a prize fight. Stare down.
That's the win.
Yeah. Praise Joe Frazier and Muhammad Ali.
So Mintz is going to shoot a pair of free throws at 73%. That's on the Miles call.
And Bert, you're, to your point, rhythm is a big part of this game, as we both know. And Alabama had it going a little bit. See if they can get it back.
So Mintz hits one out of two. This is a 9-point game, 4:45 remaining in the first half. And now Alabama will have it on the side with 11 on the shot clock. 10th free throw attempt of the day for Kentucky. Alabama is 0 of 2. Davison gets it in. Gurley on the handoff, and a foul is called. Fans will react.
Shaq, he is so adept at drawing attention.
So it's going to be Shackelford going to the free throw line. 76% shooter.
And just a little hesitation there. He can shoot it righty, too, as we both know and have heard.
He's actually a natural righty.
Correct. That's the point. And I've seen him make great passes with the right hand.
As have I.
And his finishes at the rim, he's one of the best in the country with either hand.
And he does get to the free throw line quite a bit because you have to respect his ability from the outside, and then he can't put it on the deck and get to the rim.
Now, this is a tough threesome in the backcourt. One of the premier ones in the country. You threw Davison in there with Quinterly.
Shackelford was actually recruited by Avery Johnson. And then Nate Oates, when he got the job, had to basically re-recruit him and convince him to come from the state of California to the state of Alabama. Turned out to be the right call. And now the Crimson Tide with a 44-32 advantage.
I'll tell you, Pat Adams said it. Probably a very tough time, but he went toe-to-toe or nose-to-nose. I'm surprised that the tee wasn't called on that.
Yeah, that's a backcourt violation. Kentucky is out of sorts.
Would you agree on that?
Yeah. I mean, look, we know that things get heated, and as this thing went on and on and on, it was building as both Calipari and Oates. Mm-hmm. Keep in mind, Oates got... He got ejected for the
first time in his career.
First time in his career, 8:37 mark of the second half against Mississippi State.
I think Pat was asking John what shaving cream he uses.
Well, he definitely knows now. Up close and personal. 44-32, Alabama.
Nice early recovery, Sheway.
Davison, hop step, shot clock winding down. Quinterly lines it up. Rims out, rebound, poke to the outside. Alabama's got it.
A nice play.
Shackelford short, pops it up, no, and it wouldn't go down.
A nice pass to get him that look.
Miles got a pretty good look at it off the window.
And look at Quinterly on Shiba. You've got to take a nice hustle play. Now he gets the counter.
Gets in and one.
They've got to do more of that. They've had opportunities on those switches to go in deep and punish. And that time they take advantage by the big fella. Maybe player of the year. He's got the numbers to back it up. This kid loves the game. Accomplished at the rim.
Catch a Mountain West matchup tonight over on CBS Sports Network. San Diego State looks for a fifth straight win against Fresno State. It's coming your way at 10 o'clock Eastern Time. Free throw coming here for Oscar Tshiebwe. Second foul on Gurley. Kentucky is in the bonus. 8 points, four rebounds for Oscar Tshiebwe, native of the Republic of the Congo. Came to the United States from high school, for high school, and eventually became a McDonald's All-American.
And of course, played at West Virginia, then came down here, and he just has really developed his game totally. Much better on the offensive end. Got a little freeze jump hook in that lane. And his stroke has gotten better from early in the year.
First meeting, he had 10 points, 15 rebounds, four steals. But Kentucky is down by 10.
Yeah, he certainly fills up the sheet.
Alabama in no rush.
It is a blow by
Davison. Gives it up. Quinterly.
Automatic switch.
Cross. Quinterly. There's the right hand, and he lays it in.
He is good at the rim as well. They're mixing their game up nicely. Locked in on threes early. Now developing a little dribble drive.
Javon Quinterly, also adept with the left or the right, looks very comfortable. Toppin is popping and missed it for three.
Nice touch
home. Tshiebwe working the glass.
Stays it. So unselfish at that rim.
46-36. Crimson Tide. Keon Ellis back in. Davison, ball fake. Step back, Jay. In and out. Rebound knocked towards the baseline, and Kellen Grady's got it. Might have an issue with his eye.
Well, it's a contact, maybe? Well, yeah, it must be.
Kellen Grady is asking for some solution.
No wonder he shoots so well. Extra
corrective lenses.
Extra help.
If you just had that, Bill, it would have been a completely different career. Could have been a contender.
Exactly.
Kellen Grady from Boston. excellent feel, experienced, had a number of options in the transfer portal.
See, he's coordinated. He can do that. I don't think you could do that.
I would require a mirror.
You sure? And assistance.
You may have spoken too soon. This is where the entire arena is waiting on one contact line.
Right. Usually they might be telling they're going to play.
Oh,
that's got to be uncomfortable.
I think it took. He's trying to blink himself into a comfort zone.
Shibuya just seems like such a nice young guy, doesn't he?
There was a fan holding a sign, young fan, before the game, and he went from the layup line area to go seek him out to take a picture with him. Brought him down seven rows from the stands.
You could learn a little humility from that as he steps up, takes a deep one.
Shibuya, no, battle for the loose ball. It's a tie-up, possession arrow to Kentucky as Brooks got his hands on it. Coming up, AT&T at the half. Greg Clark and Seth will recap the current top 16 seeds for this year's NCAA tournament. And they'll get you caught up on all the early scores and highlights. It's coming up on AT&T at the half. Davion Mintz getting the start along with Toppin with the injuries to Ty Washington and Xavier Wheeler.
And Grady running the point really here. Got a little bump using it. He's taking over. Vince playing off the ball in the far corner.
Nice look from Grady. 46-38. Kentucky looking to get some stops. Just over 2 minutes to play. First half. Crowd is re-energized. The drive. Quinterly high off the window. Tipped up. Rebound foot four. Cleared by Bediako. The jumper short. From Shekelford.
Oh, and they dodged one there. Nice kick out by Bediako.
Mintz to Toppin. Nice. Entry.
Look at his hands.
Shibuya works inside off the wheel and deuce.
How about his strength? People grappling. The big fella possessing.
Kentucky cuts it to six. Davison. And they are out of sync. Steal by Mintz.
Nice. Oh, I thought that was a good play.
Foul called. Quinterly was the last line of defense.
I thought he had all ball. Would you agree or no?
On the first look, it felt like it.
Yeah, just terrific anticipation. Got the house behind you. Boy, that looked awfully good. Quinterly can't believe it.
So it's Mintz back to the free throw line. 1 of 5 from the field.
Dylan Grady's talking to Toppin out here, pulling his eye. They're laughing like he's almost you saying, I can't see out of my left eye, even though it's the right. It's a problem.
7-0 run for Kentucky. Toppin has provided energy. Davion Mintz, the transfer from Creighton, always plays with that steady hand.
He's been some good games. Vandy had a big one. A&M made a big three, made some free throws to help him win.
Here's their team's leading scorer last year, and the role was going to be different this year coming off the bench. They need him today. 46-42, 8-0 run.
Ooh.
Nice fake kick. Rojas can't hit the three. Battle for the loose ball, and a foul called underneath against Alabama.
I think Brooks with a nice shield out. Checked his man out. If he can't get the ball, why not get the jersey, huh?
That's what Juwan Gary did. Alabama has missed its last 6 3-pointers after starting the game so hot from the outside.
You live by it, you occasionally meet your demise. But I thought they had a nice mix going.
Keon Brooks Jr., 76% shooter. We'll get a pair. 1:15 left on the clock. It's a three-point game.
He's a nice player. Sometimes gets lost with these other talented kids, but he provides big lift, even on the fast break opportunities.
Yeah.
You know, fills the lane beautifully.
That Swiss Army knife.
Yeah, very much so.
You can use them.
Never made it. I got cut.
10-0 run. It's a two-point game with a minute to go in the first half. Shackelford,
good handle too. Step back, now he's got his guy.
Switch. Tshiebwe, nice. Embracing the challenge. Shackelford makes his move, flips it up. Tshiebwe with the block! And he clears it. Up ahead, Toppin. Kick. Grady, jumper. Oh, he's got it! Kellen Grady puts Kentucky in front. And the first lead of the day for the Wildcats. 13-0 run at Rupp.
It's the little things that make you a winner. Damian Mintz gets there to help out. How about the big fella? Large at the point of release. And here, a little side saddle, nylon. Woo! Who needs contact lenses? Big time. And when you play Kentucky, the push, they usually fill both corners and a little closed by a smaller guard. A little plumb bob delivery. Eddie Davidson.
13 points for Grady. Alabama has gone cold. They have missed their last six shots. They now trail 47-46. 10-second difference, shot clock, the game clock.
There's Hunter. 2-1.
Shackelford lines it up. In and out. Those were going down early.
Did they go for one? They're going to go for one.
John Calipari calls out a play from the sideline. Mintz brings it across. There's a half-second difference, shot clock, the game clock. What a run by Kentucky.
I think Grady's got to keep moving, though. Get those bumps, get an opportunity.
Tshiebwe, kick, top it, drive, outside, Brooks stripped to the ball. Opportunity, Brooks dives on the floor, saves it, and it's going to be late. Mintz's jumper would not have counted. A scramble for that loose ball, and we end with a flurry. Crazy first half in Lexington, and Kentucky leads it 47-46 over Alabama. We'll send you to Greg Gumbel, Clark Kellogg, Seth Davis with AT&T at the half coming up after these messages. Little taste of March. Back in the horse capital of the world, Lexington, Kentucky, as we check out the Buick first half stats. Alabama did cool off Kentucky. Got hot, 50% from the field. They made their free throws as well, 12 of 15, and a 13-0 run to end that first half. Iron Eagle, Bill Raftery, the rest of our crew. That was wild. Alabama was up 41-28 with about 5.5 to go in that first half, and then from that point on, it was all Kentucky.
Jack in threes, but of course, Kellen Grady for one, and Tshiebwe just outstanding play. These two guys have lit it up. They tell him playing off the ball here. You know that's his favorite little jumper, that corner. Gets himself the belt. Magnificent play. The block here by Tshiebwe, and why not the counter? Living and paying red deep. Trey Kellen Grady, despite some difficulties with the eye.
Kentucky is 15-0 at Rupp this season. Their only losses to Duke, Notre Dame, LSU, Auburn, and Tennessee. They enter action at 21-5, number four in the country, 10-3 in the SEC. Alabama have had some good wins, had a couple of rough losses. 7-6 in conference play.
Little fade screen for Quinterly with a little horns look.
Quinterly turns and turns it over. Tshiebwe leads the Kentucky attack and now into the hands of Mintz.
And let Grady really do some point direction.
Topping out front. 30 seconds gone by in the second half here at Rupp. Grady swing it. Nine to shoot. Mintz.
Automatic switch, got size down.
Brooks, the jumper is silky smooth.
The difficulty is tackling for a kid that doesn't have the size to counter that deep J.
And Kentucky up by three. Alabama has missed 10 straight three-pointers.
Look at this matchup here.
Quirley shifting gears.
Look at that kid work.
Gets the roll.
And Nick Marinello, an old pal, that's his high school coach. Told him a few things in his day. Nice blow by using the left.
Entry. Tshiebwe turns in a crowd. And he gets knocked around. And Alabama's got an opportunity here with Ellis.
I thought he was going to...
Wasn't going to get the call, and he realized it.
Exactly. As you know, there's so many NBA games that would have been on the offense.
High screen. Quinterly swing. Ellis tried to dump it inside, and it's picked off by Brooks.
The hands defensively by Kentucky being in the right spots has been excellent.
Six Alabama turnovers. Mintz gives up his dribble. Grady has been very much under control in his approach here this afternoon. Toppin, drive, missed it. Offensive board, putback goes for Shigwe.
Over Bediako, 7 feet tall, some strength. Nice defense, they got a nice play, jump ball on that attack.
Whew. What a turn here in Lexington.
That should have been a floater in that particular play, but you just see the using the offhand there against a pretty darn good shot blocker.
Three early second half turnovers for Alabama. They trail Kentucky by three. Out front, Mintz.
Mintz running what Grady normally does.
And contact there as Quinterly got bodied up with Mintz.
He tried to jump that passing lane just a little tardy on it.
So now J.D. Davison will check in, and he replaces Javon Quinterly. Nate Oates coaching him up. The toughness of Kentucky on display. And things were going in the wrong direction. He just flipped the switch at the end of the first half.
And this kid, too, has been really terrific. Grady.
Seven to shoot.
Nice duck in.
Ball was tipped. Shigwe. Kick it out. They're going to have to fire. Toppin. Oh, he banks it in. A three.
You got to count it.
A complete bailout.
Pretty good defensive set. Can't hang your heads if you're Bama.
54-48. Davison. Off the probe and kick. Davison, he can quiet a crowd.
I'll tell you, that was a big-time counter. That was an excellent defensive set by Kentucky.
McDonald's All-American from Leo Hatchie, Alabama. Blocked on the inside. It's going the other way. Ellis, Euros.
Pretty, huh?
Couldn't
pretty
get the finger roll. Rebound. Gary upstairs. It's good, and a foul. Keon Ellis showing off the muscles. And a chance at a three-point play.
Tell you what, we've seen him do it from outside off the bounce and hanging around the rim here big time to finish the deal and take the hit. Well, this is a high-level performance right now. Ref's letting them play a little bit. A lot of body contact at both ends of the floor.
Ellis has been tremendous.
They missed one shot that first half.
Toppin may have been banged up just a bit. Ellis is 5 of 6 from three-point territory, and he now has 20 points. Junior college transfer from Florida, Southwestern State.
And this is the end where he is really tough. A little lateral movement, contains the bounce.
One-point lead for Kentucky.
Tucked in. Look at that little quick hook.
Shigwe. Nice. Slapped away by Ellis, and a turnover. Saved by Gary.
Nice read by Ellis.
Up ahead, Davison. Oh, he is a flash going to the rim. Knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Brooks.
How much quicker would he be with a haircut?
you think it's holding him back?
Oh, goodness, is he. Dynamite going to the rim.
Hasn't had an official haircut since second grade. He does a little self-trim occasionally.
Our crack research, we found out that the last time he tipped for a haircut was second grade.
Like you.
He gets a snip here and there.
Corner. Miles. Good look at stroke. Excuse me. Shackelford with a three.
Used the screen beautifully.
And that's an 8-0 run now for Alabama. 56-54. Shigwe kicked it out for Grady.
That was a little discard.
That's a play on. Grady connects.
Whoa.
On a three ball for Grady.
Nate is beside himself on the sideline.
He thought there was a fend out from Grady. No call. 57-56 Kentucky. Jumper. Gary short. Follows it. Gary drives in. Stripped to the ball. And a break opportunity. Grady long strides. Lob it up. Oh! A special delivery. Big going way upstairs.
Turnover here.
Davison lost it, out of bounds.
Goodness, how high can you fly? The open floor, I thought that was out of bounds. Brady, beat you outside and why not? Dropping one, elevation. Oh my goodness, Bert, send it in. Big time, Kentucky on a roll.
Kentucky up by three, and it's time for our fast analysis presented by AT&T 5G.
Well, we talked about him getting the Oscar and maybe the player of the year. Just fantastic. Running the floor, seals his guy, particularly because of the mismatch, clearly at a disadvantage. He gets himself to the rim, and he's very good with both hands, but just magical how that ball is attracted to him. He uses a little body pump. He has a great understanding to read where the charm is coming off. And a desire to control the glass, and he does it big time.
12 points, 7 rebounds, defensive presence as well. Oscar Tshiebwe, he's a bruiser, and you could see how competitive he is. And he's also very encouraging, as you notice, with his teammates.
Very much so. Got a nice way about himself. He's got to do a better job with the rebounds, though. 7, he's got to get the doubles.
Ibaba Tshiebwe in attendance. Oscar is one of 6 kids. That would require a lot of tickets.
I think they can afford them here in Kentucky.
59-56, Wildcats.
A little stacked look with a pin down. Handled well on Brady. Now he's off the ball. Mintz is running it.
Mintz watched by Ellis.
If they can get him going a little again, he's got to be able to use the dribble more. But they've won that little dribble handoff.
Kick. Tshiebwe. Splash.
Goodness. Charm, talent, and desire, big time.
7-0, Wildcats run. Davison handling it, and it's Shackelford off the ball. Nice. Ellis swing inside, layup goes. Nice cut by Gurley, and good vision.
And that's what they do beautifully. You have a good understanding of reading the next logical pass, and who was it? But Ellis with the delivery.
Kentucky is 6 of 8 from the field in this second half. They lead by 3.
And Brady's much busier today. A little nickel dimer out.
Shackelford just swinging at the ball and a touch foul call. Just about 6 minutes gone by in this highly competitive Alabama-Kentucky matchup. Crimson Tide could do no wrong. During stretches of the first half, Kentucky battled back, took the lead at the break by 1 on a jump shot from Kellen Brady.
Got to be careful with that arm because of the prior incident. Nice step back.
Brady,
yes, sir! Get some separation. Get him organized.
64-58, Brady stepping forward in the absence of Washington and Wheeler. He's got 19 points, 5 of 6. From beyond the arc.
Could you imagine earlier in the year, a little deep one by Miles.
In and out, it was halfway down. Rebound controlled by Tshiebwe.
Nice little play by Ellis. Again, his reaction early in the year against Carolina. Cal took him out, Brady, because he wasn't shooting the ball. And that changed his whole year and demeanor.
Brady, drive to the rim. Rejected.
Nice play.
Sola Gurley with the block.
And a nice save by Brady with the slap back.
Brady, shot clock winding down, trying to make it happen. Swing it, Toppin, tosses it up. Off the rim, no. Tshiebwe battles.
Unbelievable the amount of possession.
Oh, Brady didn't see it.
He does now.
And a busted play. Brady with a downtown hit.
He's all smiles and why not?
He lost a contact lens. He hasn't been looking at times, and yet it's all working out. Gurley's rainbow jumper, no, and Toppin. The pogo stick, he got poked in the eye.
And a little scrape by him, too. Brady tried to inhale. He almost got the wrath of Cal. And came up with a 3.
Toppin trying to shake it off.
Just a little scrape. This happens a lot in basketball.
Yep, he got Miles with the arm extension.
This is just incredible, right? He must have a soft derriere for that to stay close by.
Yeah.
But what presents to not only gather, but finish, and why not?
Bill, that's the top shelf analysis that we look for.
I appreciate it. Just trying to reach back for you.
13-2 run. Grady has 22 points on 6 of 7 from three-point territory.
Now, you listened to Cal Zoom. Was he next guy up kind of philosophy?
Yes. Yes, next guy up. He basically said, hey, it's hard for guys that don't play a lot for their mental preparation of, am I going to get in? Am I not going to get in? The rotation's been really tight in the second half. In fact, he's made no substitutions so far in the second half because it's working. He tried some things in the first half.
Mm-hmm. He went deep in the first half.
Grady swings it. Mintz trying to get in on it. Missed it. Oh, top down.
Flies in. How about that kid?
Fouled on the inside. Great. Constant energy from Jacob Toppin.
And talent and the ability to soar big time. This is just reaching over two, including his own teammate.
And now Toppin will shoot a pair. There are moments where he looks like Grant Hill.
Ooh,
like
high
physically
praise.
Looks like Grant Hill.
Much more enjoyable to be with.
Yeah, sorry, no comparison.
Talking about lackey personality and charm.
10 points, 6 rebounds for Jacob Toppin. No Wheeler, no Washington here this afternoon. But the challenge from John Calipari that these are the kinds of things you're going to face. And then he then made a point to say, hey, you might get to March Madness. What if someone turns an ankle? What if somebody's not available? Guys have to be ready in the biggest games of the year.
That's why you have to practice hard, be diligent, understand the scouting report, and be prepared.
It's a 15-2 run. Kentucky now leads it 69-58 over Alabama.
I'd like to see them dribble, drive, and see if they can find somebody or finish.
Ellis, kick out. Miles can't get the three. Now, this guy is the supreme rebounder in the country.
All over.
Oscar Tshiebwe.
All over. There's got to be room in the NBA for this kid.
He's got a talent.
Absolutely. Chuck Daly said if you can do one thing well, you can play in the league. Well, he certainly can rebound and get you extra possessions.
We saw Paul Millsap lead the country 3 times and found a spot in the NBA, then added to his game. Toppin, he's feeling it.
Boy, the growth. Boy, impressive.
71-58, 10-0 run.
Now settling again. No.
Jumper doesn't go for Quinterly, and it's out of bounds the other way. The bottom has dropped out for Alabama.
And not getting to the free throw line either.
The Kentucky Wildcats up against the wall in the first half, and they came out swinging, and they've been outstanding within the conference.
Two good teams. They've, of course, one of those talented kids in that league. Egan Murray, another guy that's had a sensation here at Iowa. But Michigan, I think it's an important game for them. Wouldn't you?
Agreed. And we will see Michigan next week here on CBS as they play host to Illinois.
They're playing better lately. Diabate, Dickinson, Brooks. I mean, they got some kids who can ring the bell and get it done.
Alabama shooting 39% in the second half. Kentucky 64% since the break. They are 7 of 11 on three-pointers this afternoon.
And Ellis is a little high-low. They haven't run that at all. Now you got to deny that ball to Brooks before the, and then harass the passer as well.
Jusson Holt has checked in for the first time for Nate Oates, and he gets the block shot. The freshman from Roswell, Georgia.
They're raving about his ability to shoot the ball. Hasn't shown it a lot this year. Watching him yesterday, he's got a beautiful looking stroke.
Shot clock is down to 6. Mintz off the double team. Nice. Sets up Brooks for a 3. Bottom.
Nice replace by Brooks. Great attention to detail. Just didn't hang at the top of the key. No post presence now. He's got to be off the dribble.
4-minute stretch with no point production for Alabama. 13-0 run. Quinterly, one-on-one with Grady.
Automatic switching on the perimeter.
Ellis now picked up by Grady with 10 to shoot. Set it up. Rojas turns. Rojas trying to drive. Lost it. Shot clock down to three. Ellis jumper. Short. Rebound to the corner and controlled by Alabama. Out of bounds off of Kentucky.
Holt, what a nice job. He tipped it to his teammate.
Got a substitution here. Shackelford in.
Quinterly, I think, out.
It is.
They've been able to get it going, those two guards.
Even amidst that impressive run in the first half, it was mostly Keon Ellis who was just shooting lights out. Halfway point, second half.
Well, I would have just backed my man in.
Shackelford drive, kick for Ellis, 10 to shoot.
Look at this defense, though. Big reaction.
Toppin digs in against Ellis. Step back, kick, Miles. Shot clock winding down. They have to hoist it. Rojas misses for three. Offensive rebound, Holt. Long jumper doesn't go for Shackelford.
Well, look who's got it, number 34.
Alabama was up by 13 points. They now trail by 16. It's been 46-17 Kentucky since the high water mark for the Crimson Tide. Inside, Tshiebwe.
He does a little bit in here just to keep everybody honest. Nice slap away by Rojas.
A defensive play triggers the break. Ellis gives it up. Miles not looking to shoot it initially. Shackelford is.
What a great sensation.
Got a three.
A nice find, too.
Nate Oates trying to urge his team on. They had something in that first half. They just have not been able to find it. And a timeout taken by John Calipari. With 8:54 to play in regulation. 13-point lead for the Kentucky Wildcats at home against Alabama. This Thursday, our spirits are lifted with the return to new episodes of TV's number one new comedy, Ghosts. The critics call it drop-dead funny and thoroughly charming, and it's just been certified fresh by Rotten Tomatoes. Ghosts is back. A brand new episode starts at 9, 8 Central, Thursday, here on CBS.
And Bert, you know, you watch this Kentucky team, as we both have during this year, their defense, their reaction defensively, being in the right spot, covering for one another. This guy's done it for a long time. That's why he's in the HOF. Amazing. Two starters gone and seamless.
Ty Washington, Xavier Wheeler, both unavailable today for Kentucky.
Collins again, he did a nice shot when he was in there, using the dribble again.
Oh, Grady cracked a slam down on the follow. Damian Collins,
two
foul offensive board and jam.
Two followed one bird, bared the backside.
76-61, Kentucky. Bediako, we had not seen him in this second half.
Oh, goodness, they're really having their troubles. Because they usually use him for the ball screen and not to make a play, but I just love this attention to detail. Just moving in as two go after the dribble drive, and Kellen Grady has really done a nice job mixing his game up. Back screen on the five man.
Collected. Ellis got a piece.
Good defender.
Plenty of time on the shot clock for Mintz. Swing it. Collins showing off the jumper. No. Air ball.
If I were him, I wouldn't have looked over at John.
That's the wrong place to look.
Exactly. Look at us. You know, we have sympathy. Now, look at this Alabama team. They need something inside as the season progresses, too. Just put pressure on the other bigs.
The fake by Shackelford. The kick. And Ellis cans another. He has been stone cold from outside the arc.
A lot of pro scouts here, obviously, looking at Tshiebwe, but this kid, he's got their eye as well.
Jab step try by Mintz. Now Grady one-on-one with Ellis.
There's the weave, and occasionally on the third one, they attack.
Crossover. Mintz denied. He got smothered on the inside by Bediako.
Another one's his early three here.
Shackelford fake.
He's got a nice step back game. Ice, force him one way again.
Gets it back from Bediako. Shackelford swing.
He's not getting into the lane, Shackelford.
Ellis tried it high off the window. Rebound fought for. Bediako got his hands on it. And it's going to stay with Alabama. They'll have 4 seconds to work with on the shot clock when we come back to Rupp Arena. Game summary, Kentucky hot shooting at the end of the first half. It carried over here in the second half, and the points in the paint category. Alabama has not been able to match up in that area, and Kellen Grady has been terrific for Kentucky.
At Boston's contribution. The Kentucky just really much more active than I've seen him. Looking for his shot, a little discard earlier, and here, pretty good reaction. The supple, sinewy exterior. And talking about great players, huh?
Wow, a legend, Dan Issel, the Issel missile. Terrific career here at Kentucky, and then on to the pros, then an NBA head coach as well. Hey, you come to Lexington, you're going to see some legends. They're always around. Everybody always comes home at some point.
You're always enamored with stars.
Yes.
But he's before his time, wouldn't you say?
No doubt. Yeah. If he played today, one of those, forget it. He fits right in.
Nice open middle. One of the few times they've gotten an opportunity to come up empty first and then to finish.
Ellis is there off the miss by Davison. 76-66 Kentucky. Alabama hanging around enough with 6:35 to play. 14 offensive rebounds for the Crimson Tide.
Ellis really doing a nice job trying to guard Grady. Looks like Ellis got hurt.
Turn around. It goes for Shibwe.
Hurt his hand, I think.
And Ellis is having some troubles right now. Shibwe, 16 points, 11 rebounds. He's looking at that right hand, trying to flex it.
And Davison loves this right hand, too, going to the goal. Nice stand at home by Toppin.
It doesn't hurt that much.
How about that?
Ellis sticks it from long range. 78-69, under 6 minutes to go. Ince watched out front by Shackelford.
And Grady's got miles now, might be able to do something.
Feed it to the post. Shibwe.
Oh, yeah. He doesn't really, that was not one of them. He's one of those freezing and a quick up with the knockdown.
The baby hook gives him 18. Lob, catch, and release from Bediako.
And Davis is really unselfish. He had a clean look there.
80-71, Kentucky. Trading baskets is not going to work out for Alabama.
Got to string a few together. Stops. And then back with Ellis.
Now it's Mintz.
And it was saying Bediako's got to put some more weight on it. And just the Shibwe with that body able to move him around.
Grady gives it up. Brooks, one dribble and a J. It's way off and caught by Davison. A flash up the floor. Davison is fouled as he tumbles into the photographers along the baseline.
How about Brooks saving that basket, too? That's the case it went in. Serious hops. This kid's got a motor as well.
It's got that extra gear and so dangerous off the dribble. J.D. Davison shoots it at 71% at the free throw line.
Making strides with his shot, too. He's going to have a great career down there.
Won a state title as a junior at Calhoun. Two-time Mr. Basketball in the state of Alabama.
Had a big Zags game early in the year, too.
Davison looks to attack, plays at that fast pace.
Look at those numbers right now, Bert. Another one, they're in touch. No. 73, he makes it.
Noah Gurley will check in, replacing Bediako.
I think for the physicality. See Charlie Henry on the sideline. He stepped in when they got thrown out. Ran into the locker room. They were spraying him with water like it was champagne.
Kentucky 80, Alabama 73. Pressure now being applied by Alabama. They'll back off with Ellis defending Grady.
Look how graceful he is defensively. There he goes.
The steal. Ellis, and then Grady gets it back.
Nice job ragging
the teeter-totter here in Lexington. Looked like Alabama was going to have a chance to cut into this Kentucky lead. Instead, the Wildcats have it with 15 to shoot. Grady, a deep one. He's got it.
Wow.
Kellen Grady locked and loaded.
That is a message. You want to strip me? I'm going to make you pay. Some range.
Davison kick. Ellis ball fake. Drive. Trying to hook a pass inside. And it's out of bounds off of Toppin.
Whew. The logo on the left side. Just a little breakdown jam step. Nylon from deep. Nailing it.
25 points, 7 of 8 from three-point territory. It's a Kentucky high for Kellen Grady.
Davison, just go. Joe, you can go by it.
Davison, help from Shibwe. Kick out. Gurley, short on a three.
Good hustle.
Rebound, stick back. That will not go. The miss by Shackelford. Kentucky up 10 with possession. Under 4 minutes to play.
Off the ball with Shackelford. See if Grady gets himself free using that bump and separation. Grady really taking a blow now, inhaling.
Mintz penetrates. Shot clock down to 2, down to 1.
Oh, boom! Off the window! That's 2. Brooks got 1. You sort of know it's your day when that happens.
Kentucky up by 12 with the shot clock expiring. Cool Mintz to make it happen. Jumper short from Shackelford. And Kentucky with 2:55 on the clock in control at home against Alabama.
And a double-double machine got that last rebound.
Brooks pops to the outside, Toppin, hair against hair. Grady stripped to the ball.
Off the hands.
Ellis has got
should
another.
Should be on Grady.
And it will be. Keon Ellis knocking the ball free with those quick hands.
Is he something? You make shots like this, you're going to earn mints. A little kiss. Pretty finish. Damian.
To the crew, Joaquin Niemann atop the leaderboard, one shot in front of Cameron Young.
There's some great names on that leaderboard.
Our game reset, Kentucky up 85-73, 2:34 to play. Wildcats have shot it at 60% in the second half, 6 of 8 from downtown.
Really impressed with Ellis' defense at home. Grady's had a great, great afternoon. Ellis, he can't guard all five. You know, they switch on and off. But Kellen Grady is rising his level of play today.
Kentucky coming off a loss to Tennessee. They have not lost 2 in a row this season. Davison, they crowd him. Gurley goes in for the big jam and foul.
That's the first time we've really seen a time dive to the front of the rim. And it's just excellent. Right down the middle, right down the pipe, big time bang. Unfortunately, I didn't get too many of these inside that restraining area. It's open. Some deep ones and occasionally a little dribble drive.
Gurley shoots it at just 57% at the free throw line. His team is down by 10. And he cuts it to 9. Good stroke. 2:21 to play. In regulation.
And this is smart. Let Mintz bring it up. A little run and jump there. Ellis on Grady.
Mintz directing traffic. Shibwe back in against Gurley. And a foul called on the floor.
A little bump by Gurley.
Third round coverage of the Genesis Invitational coming up next on CBS. Available right now on PGATour.com and CBSSports.com. Third foul on Gurley. Toss it in along the baseline with 2:08 on the clock. 9-point lead for Kentucky. Clean entry. Grady. Chigwe driving in. Bank shot. Doesn't go, but a foul on Gurley.
Well, he puts that strength in. It's number four, I believe. But the ability to turn the shoulder and get to the rim. And two innocent bystanders enjoying what they're seeing.
They are engaged. Wheeler and Washington along the sideline. No timetable. Looking at the Kentucky schedule. You know, the games, they come fast and furious. Home for LSU on Wednesday night, then at Arkansas for Kentucky. Alabama will be at Vanderbilt on Tuesday night.
I think they're 4 out of 6 on the road, and they finished strong at home.
Kentucky undefeated at Rupp this season. Chigwe misses on the second attempt, tracked down by Brooks.
Just quicker.
So they can use more clock, 10 to shoot. Mintz out front, watched by Shackelford. Shot clock down to 5. Grady peeks at the clock.
Nice
flips defenders and couldn't get it to go.
Look who's there.
Chigwe cleans it up on the interior, and he says they're too small to guard him.
Chigwe does it his way. Magnificent around that rim.
21 points, 13 rebounds. And a major flush by Darius Miles. 10-point game with just over a minute to go.
Look for a trap.
156th all-time meeting between Alabama and Kentucky. Crimson Tide had it going early, and Kentucky with a big-time rally.
Oh, wow.
Grady, no.
Look at that.
Put down. Alabama looking around.
Nobody put a body on Brooks. Score, then you got to start giving some fouls.
Shackelford a 3. Off the rim, no.
Look at
rebound,
that.
Davison. Shackelford, another 3 try, and that one goes down.
They're going to take a timeout.
With 43 seconds to play, 9-point game. We'll come back for the finish in Lexington after this. Coming up, third round coverage of the Genesis Invitational. It's next year on CBS. You can check it out right now on PGAtour.com and CBSSports.com. The best way has been the Chigwe for Kentucky. 90-81, the Wildcats with the lead and 43 seconds left. Kentucky looking to improve to 22-5 on the season, 11-3 in SEC action.
And Bert, now you can see a full court press fronting, and I would think at least one catch and try and get a trap. And nobody big on the ball, so you're going to have good vision and probably send some one or two long. Yeah, they do. Chigwe at the other end.
Toppin bounces in for Mintz.
Trying to give it, but they're not.
Rushes ahead, lobs it up, and he put it off the front of the rim. It was not something Kentucky needed.
No, bring it out.
It basically works to Alabama's favor, but Ellis couldn't convert from the outside. Rebound controlled by Alabama, cleared by Holt. Jumper doesn't go.
Look at Chigwe.
Chigwe's got out of board with 2 seconds left.
Get out of my way, right?
And Ellis fouls Grady at midcourt with 19.4 on the clock.
Well, this kid is something else. Don't you agree?
Big time.
His pursuit of missed shot. Look at those hands, too. I mean, you're not going to get anything out of there.
The big mitts, the 7'5 wingspan.
And the attitude, right? Persistent.
Big jump from his sophomore year numbers to his junior year numbers. Basically doubled his production in both categories. Scoring and rebounding. And now Alabama's going to back off. What a Wildcat win. Kentucky rallies and knocks off Alabama to sweep the season series. 90-81 the final here at Rupp. John Calipari, he pushes the right buttons today.
Whatever he does, it works. Not a happy guy going into this ball game, but goodness.
Keeping pace with Auburn in the SEC. Alabama falls to 500 in the conference. 17-10 overall for the Crimson Tide. So for Bill Raftery, the rest of our crew, Ian Eagle saying so long from Lexington. Coming up next, third round coverage of the Genesis Invitational. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports. Have a great day, everybody. Yes.